and welcome. This is Chani Nevnani and you are watching It's Tomorrow News. Thousands flee severe flooding in New Zealand. Severe flooding forced thousands of residents in New Zealand's South Island to flee their homes on Wednesday and left hundreds of tourists stranded at the remote Milford Sound beauty spot. The Southland region declared a state of emergency after being deluged with more than 1,000 mm of rainfall in 60 hours, triggering landslides on major roads and causing rivers to burst their banks. Authorities told residents in the low-lying areas of Goree and Mataura to evacuate immediately early on Wednesday as floodwaters in the Mataura River peaked, warning those further downstream in Windham to prepare to leave. Residents were advised to grab medication, clothing and identification documents and then head to higher ground. Power to affected areas was cut off as a precaution and evacuation centers were set up in local churches and schools. Floodwaters washed away sections of the only road to Milford Sound, a popular hiking spot for international tourists, and EMS said almost 200 people were being airlifted to nearby Tinanao. Only two minor injuries have been reported after a landslide hit a hut on the Rootburn walking track, with both people receiving treatment at the scene. Nearly 400 others, including 195 tourists, are trapped in the nearby township of Milford Sound and will have to wait until at least Wednesday to be rescued after flooding cut off the highway in and out of the town. The weather chaos in the picturesque Florent area of the Southland at the bottom of the South Island hit during the peak summer tourist season and generated a state of emergency for the region. Meanwhile, a huge earthquake of magnitude 5.2 has hit off the coast of New Zealand today, according to the United States Geological Survey. The earthquake was reported at 10:47 p.m. local time today. Although there have been no reports of damage, some members of the public reported feeling the shudder. The USGS reported the earthquake hit a depth of 282 kilometers. According to GeoNet, who provides geological hazard information for New Zealand, there were reports of 11,000 people feeling the quake. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Chani Nevnani. For more weather updates, do like, share and subscribe our channel.